Devahuti was not at all sorry at giving up her material comforts, but she was very much aggrieved at the separation of her son. It may be questioned here that if Devahuti was not at all sorry to give up the material comforts of life, then why was she sorry about losing her son? Why was she so attached to her son? The answer is explained in the next verse. He was not an ordinary son. Her son was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. One can give up material attachment. Therefore, only when one has attachment for the Supreme Person. This is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Param Drishtva Nivartate. Only when one actually has some taste for spiritual existence, can he be reluctant to follow the materialistic way of life. Thus ends the Bhakti Vedanta purport. So now that Lord Kapila left his mother after giving her instructions on spiritual life, she relished all those association from her son in receiving transcendental knowledge. But as soon as he left, it struck her that she is separated from her son. And this created a great misery for her. She was affected by separation from her son. Unlike she was not so much affected when Kardamuni left. But when Kapila Muni left, Kapila Dev left, we see here that she is very much affected. So Prabhupada explains here a very important concept. Is it how spiritual attachment, emotional spiritual attachment, also exists. Even though so much of knowledge she received from Lord Kapila with respect to separation of matter and spirit. So any kind of attachment in this material world will appear stupid to anyone who understands the difference between matter and spirit. So it is surprising. There's a great message here. She was not so much attached to Kardama Muni. After he left, she was not aggrieved so much. When it came to her son, she was very much aggrieved. And the reason is because the son was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Somebody who has perfected the understanding, I am not this body, I am the spirit, should not be affected. According to normal logic, according to impersonal logic. But Devahuti, Lord Kapila Leela demonstrates that unless you become attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, simply that transcendental intelligence to separate matter and spirit is not completion of spiritual life. Not only completion, it is only the beginning. Separating matter and spirit is only beginning. That I am not this body is only the beginning. But unless one understands that he is part and parcel, who he is, whom he belongs to, that realization, unless that understanding and realization is there, then there is no complete freedom from ignorance. The impersonalist, the separate matter and spirit, because of the detachment from matter, material miseries, they may be liberated from material miseries, But it is very difficult for them to be detached from material pleasure, subtle, first and then gross. Because by nature, every living entity is seeking rasa, not only in the conditioned state, but also in the liberated state. So this is the evidence, this Leela of Devahuti and Lord Kapila is the evidence that there is a transcendental attachment. There is transcendental personality. Attachment means personality. That means beyond the matter, there are persons and there are personal attachments. And that personal rasa of love, all these things exist. In fact, such attachment, it is to create such attachment, the Lord takes avatara in this material world. By getting attracted to the transcendental leelas of the Lord in his avatara, in this material world, who appears before our mundane senses. By becoming attached to that, we automatically become attached to, because the avatara is non-different from the Lord himself, is Lord himself. Even though he has taken a prakata form as a flesh or as sound or as Bhagavad Gita, as intelligence in Bhagavad Gita, or as prasadam, different ways in which the Lord manifests himself in matter for the sake of the conditioned soul who can only relate with matter. If we take advantage of association of such manifestations in this material world, then it is as we are not associating with matter, but we are associating with the Lord himself. So our spirit, by associating with the Lord, gets purified and then can experience this higher taste. And unless that higher taste is experienced, one cannot be liberated really. It can fall down any time. So what is that higher taste? That higher taste is the sense of oneness and difference with the Lord. That I am part and parcel of God. I am never alone. Something is parcel means never alone. A lonely existence is an illusion. And in the material world, everybody is afflicted by this lonely existence. One aspect. And independent, lonely means independent, lonely in a material sense is called independence existence. Independent existence. Everybody in this material world, he thinks he is him. But actually he is not him. He is Amsha of Krishna. I am his part and parcel. I don't have a standalone identity. In the material world, everybody is having a standalone identity. Standalone identity means I. When that I is disconnected from the Lord, in substance, in quality, in everything, disconnected, then that is called ahankara. So our real I is trapped in forgetfulness. Real I always knows that I am Krishna. Belonging. The sense of belonging is called love. The material world, we experience love. The sense of belonging to somebody or sense of relationship with somebody because somebody gives up some kind of pleasure or protection or something, you are favored, everything, you feel love for someone who is from whom you have received something. You feel that, isn't it? The material world, love is connected to receiving something. In a family also, love exists because you receive something from the family, from the members, everything, you receive something. But actual relationship, love is coming from sense of belonging. Just like if in a family, the relationship is based on sense of belonging, it doesn't break even if you don't give and take. Is it not? Just like if sometimes the children, the son does not give respect to the parents, still the parents don't give up the son. Why? Because there is a sense of belonging. So a relationship based on sense of belonging is real love. But here, unfortunately, sense of belonging in a family is there, but it is within the domain of Maya, based on false identities. So real, in the same way, love of God cannot happen unless one realizes a sense of belonging to Him. Not only I, everybody, every jiva belongs to Him. I have no separate existence other than Him, constitutionally. That is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, simultaneously one and different, the jiva from God. So unless one understands that, one sense of belonging comes, then naturally there is love, there is devotion service to please the Lord. Lord is the one who is to be served, and we are the servitors. This is our eternal position. So getting attached to Guru, getting attached to spiritual personalities, getting attached to previous acharyas, by reading their commentaries, by giving their, reading their, by hearing them. These are all spiritual attachments. Spiritual attachments gives higher taste. Just see, entire gamut of spiritual knowledge, how spirit is different from matter, is grasped by the impersonalists. Yet they are nowhere, just because they have no feelings for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They have no feelings for the Supreme Personality of Godhead because, according to them, in the absolute sense, Supreme Personality of Godhead does not exist. Many, many people have understanding, oh, God is some power, God is some power, God is some power. From that power you manifest as Krishna, as Rama and all these things. That's because they have not met a pure devotee who could give this taste of feeling of devotion and surrender to Krishna. This is exactly the gift from a spiritual master. General spiritual knowledge we can all get by reading books. But to get that mood of devotion, that you get from Prabhupada. His surrender, his feelings, his dedication, his commitment, his loyalty to his guru, to the parampara, this you don't get unless it is gifted by the spiritual master. If she don't know that, what have you got from the spiritual master? You should know that. If you have some attachment to Krishna, some attachment to pursue Krishna consciousness, these are all gifts from Prabhupada. In a moment it has come and it has stayed in your heart. We take for granted. We think Prabhupada gave us the philosophy of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. That is the least he has given us. Also knowledge oriented, Prabhupada gave us knowledge. Knowledge you can read and get also. What you learn from Prabhupada, ultimately what the real thing that you get from Prabhupada is his devotion to Krishna. When we meditate on his devotion to Krishna, we get devotion. When you meditate on his transcendental qualities of pure devotional service, the pure devotional service will also come into our heart. That purity will come into our heart. When you appreciate and glorify the purity of Srila Prabhupada, then that purity will also manifest in our heart. So therefore it is said that that spiritual advancement ultimately is made by association, not by intellectualizing. Not by intellectualizing the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. So Devahuti's attachment to her son, in the normal sense, would be seen as a weakness for Devahuti, for in her pursuit of spiritual life. The Prabhupada and the previous Acharyas glorify that particular attachment to the Supreme Lord, who Lord Kapila, who is none other than the Supreme Lord himself. In the same way, we have to be attached to Prabhupada. We have to be attached to the deities. We have to be attached to the holy name. Developing attachment to these things brings a higher taste. Slowly all this lower taste, which arises out of the three modes of material nature, Rajoguna Ruchi and Tamoguna Ruchi and Sattoguna Ruchi, all that thing will go away when there is Bhakti Ruchi, when there is devotion, attachment to the Supreme Lord. And the Lord is waiting. The Lord is seated in our heart. He is waiting for us to actually awaken our sense of belonging to Him. So bhakti means sense of belonging to Krishna. Do we feel sense of belonging to Krishna? When you feel a sense of belonging, automatically there is a sense of protection. I belong to Krishna, so Krishna will protect me. It's not that I have to pray to Krishna to protect me. If I have a sense of belonging, there's no need to pray for protection. I belong to Him. If I belong to Him, the child feels I belong to the father, then he also has confidence that the father will protect him. Protect him, provide him, maintain him, help him, everything. And the existence is completely purified by such awakening of sense of belonging to the Supreme Lord. Any questions?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. In some cases when we are going through pastimes of Srila Prabhupada, there will be sometimes certain humanly aspects of Prabhupada. Say for instance, when he was in the US in the 1965 initial days, he was not getting enough success.
Enough?
Success for the first 1 year. So Prabhupada himself says that, you know, he had gone many times to this India shipping company to see when is the next time the ship is going to India. And I mean, he says that, and of course later on there is success. But somebody who goes through these kind of human aspects of Prabhupada, they will think why Prabhupada was like this. You know, you should have had some confidence on Krishna or something like that, you know.
You should have had some?
He should have confidence on Krishna. Why he went to the shipping company to see whether there is a, you know, next ship to India. So these kind of things I do come across. So how do we take certain humanly aspects of, because that is how, I mean, they manifest the Leela.
No, even those aspects are not human aspects. If Krishna accepts defeat in his Leela with the Gopas, and as a punishment, Krishna has to carry them on his shoulders, can we say that is a human aspect? In Bhakti Rasa, defeat, uncertainty, anxiety, concern, anxiety whether you will succeed or not, these are all part of Bhakti Rasa. One should understand that Krishna is also enjoying everything. The Lord enjoys the devotee every moment. The pure devotees, every moment he enjoys. That is Bhakti Rasa. It's not one-sided. So if Prabhupada went behind Scindia Shipping Company to Sumati Muraji again and again and feeling anxiety whether she would give the ticket or not, send him or not, that anxiety is a secondary aspect. Behind that there is a primary rasa operating in his heart. So one should not take these feelings of Prabhupada as standalone feelings. Behind that there is a very deep feelings for taking the mission of his guru forward, which is transcendental rasa. So under the umbrella of a transcendental rasa, so-called so many mundane dualistic rasas are accommodated. If somebody says, if Prabhupada says that your actions, the situation is creating blood pressure for me, he writes in one letter, it's creating blood pressure for me. An impersonalist will say, hey, what kind of a spiritualist is he? Some organization, some problem is there, he's getting blood pressure. How much is he detached? He's not detached. He's getting blood pressure. Ordinary man is, they'll say. So they don't see the primary bhakti rasa in that blood pressure. Why is he getting blood pressure? There's some other rasa which is causing that blood pressure. So that is the reason why we always caution. There's this peace of mind, trying to be peaceful, is a big contamination for Vaishnava. He likes to take anxiety. Even a neophyte, he takes anxiety, it contributes towards purification. Anxiety to collect, anxiety to finish a project, anxiety for these things. All these things, you should not say, I am a spiritualist, I should not take anxiety. No, who said that? You should take anxiety, that's what will purify you. How much tension you take to serve the Supreme Lord, serve Prabhupada's mission is what will purify you. So it's very subtle. These are very subtle things. unless one understands the personal philosophy of Krishna consciousness. Of course, we have to see the anxiety. Now, this kind of anxiety also has a pure anxiety and a mixed and a component of anxiety. For instance, if you think that, look, everybody is watching me, I have not did any collection for so long. So that means then I has come, I rasa has come there. Your anxiety is mixed with for social gratification. Not that your anxiety is that I mean unable to please Prabhupada. So constantly the devotees try to, you know, have selfless feelings, but should have feelings. Selfless feelings. Self means it's not because of me I feel, because I am unable to please Prabhupada and Krishna, therefore I feel anxiety, I feel blood pressure, I feel everything. That is actual bhakti. So moment, no doubt, if anxiety comes, okay, some result is not coming, anxiety comes. It's a great opportunity for us to check how much of that anxiety is due to my own frustration of material expectation, of social gratification, of success and failure. Or it is really anxiety of success and failure for Srila Prabhupada. If I succeed, it is success of Prabhupada. If I fail, it is failure for Prabhupada's mission. That kind of feeling should be there. So this is a churning process for the devotee. Constantly, internally, the devotee is purifying his bhakti. And if he does not have feeling, then there is no, then spiritual life becomes dry. So there's nothing like, as far as Prabhupada is concerned, there's nothing like, it is operating in another plane of bhakti rasa. So people say that, but we don't feel that. When we hear Prabhupada speaking like this, we as devotees, we only see his play with Krishna. He and Krishna playing. We only see that. We don't see that he is. So in my impersonalists, they will analyze and say he is human. What does he, divine means all these things is not there. Who said divine, all these things are not there? Even in the Supreme Personality of God, it is there. He also forgets he is the Supreme Personality of God. Success, failure, all these things is there. So many different kinds of anxieties. You will see, if you read Mahabharata, see Krishna in different situations, so much of anxiety, like ordinary human being. Are he is Supreme Personality of God, why should he be worried? The goal is not about worry or not worry, the goal is about Anandamaya Vyasat. There is rasa there, the devotees. Rasa with devotees is the highest principle of existence. That people don't see. If you intellectualize, you will see that he is also ordinary. He is so many times, he is lord of everything, he knows everything. Suppose he goes into jnanic platform. Krishna doesn't want to go into that jnanic platform. I am Paramatma, I know everything. But still he will discuss in great anxiety, now how do we do this now? He knows. He goes to Duryodhana, he knows. He will not accept. But for him, result is not the main thing. For him, it was a rasa of going to him and getting rejected for peace. That was a rasa. For that he went. So rasa, suppose it is not for rasa. Anyway, I know I'll get defeated. Why should I go? If it is only for result, why should I go? So then they will say, Krishna is also an ordinary human being. He already knew. Why did he have to attempt to go and you know, try peace? He need not have gone at all. Similarly, some devotees will think, why Krishna is not telling me, why I wasted this time with this donor? He never gave one check also. He should have told me earlier. After all, I am serving him. He should have told me earlier. So you also should not go to collect for results. You should also go for rasa. You should go for rasa. Rasa of seva. Everything belongs to him. In 1 second, everything he can. Whole material world is running under his sanction. We don't see any absolute limitation in Krishna consciousness movement. Any other question?
Yeah, Hare Krishna Prabhu. President Devahuti was very much attached to his son. So then you said we should in similar way we should get attached to Prabhupada and deities. So how do I develop that attachment to Prabhupada and deities?
See, first is gratitude. Gratitude is an expression of Prabhupada feeling that you belong to me. Because Prabhupada feels you belong to me, first you should believe that Prabhupada feels that I belong to him. That itself we should not doubt. When you have become his disciple, Prabhupada feels that I belong to him. Because of that, he has showered care, he has showered transcendental knowledge, he has showered his shraddha, his faith, his devotion into my heart. So if I have anything today, it has come from him. This requires little intellectualizing to start with. Then you have to appreciate this. Just like you see, the other day I was reading one quote, some Westerner had told. Where would the world be if Indians didn't invent zero? It's a good point. The point is, now we play around with zero like zero. When zero was not existing in this world, appearance of zero into the mind of man, is it a small thing? Ideas don't come easily. Once it comes, it becomes zero. Sabko malum hai zero hai. The concept of 1, 2, 3, 4, and what's there? It is always there. In the modern times, I'm saying the modern civilization. The modern civilization, zero is all eternal. Mathematics all eternal. But in the modern civilization, modern history of modern civilization, zero manifested at a time. And manifested that in India. Now zero is everywhere. Without the concept of zero, IT cannot exist. Without the concept of zero, the mathematics cannot exist. But at some time it manifested from when it was not existing. Why I am giving this example? Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Now you know. Don't take for granted. 90% of the world still doesn't know that. You know that. Why you know that? Because Prabhupada gave that in the modern world. Krishna is Sarvakarana Karana. Who gave it to the modern world? Where did you receive it from? Prabhupada. Now don't take for granted. How does this taking for granted happen? No, I know, as if I know always. I knew always. Your own brothers, your own classmates and all, they are lost in ignorance. They don't know idea. But you got it. That Krishna is Supreme Personality of God. That there is a spiritual world. Like this whole ambit of entire thing, where did you get it from? Not a joke. This is not a joke. So you feel gratitude to Prabhupada. Every knowledge that I have, it has come from Prabhupada. When you have it, when you get it, you take for granted. And you think it is yours. But at some time it was not yours, it came to you. So there is a source. Gratitude is required for Prabhupada, for all the devotees who have contributed to receiving your book from Prabhupada, everywhere. Everywhere little gratitude is there, you have to offer that gratitude. Gratitude again is not black and white. So many instruments Prabhupada uses to reach Krishna consciousness to the masses. So everybody plays a small role. So we have to, just like in the outside material world, in normal, if you're a karmi itself, the Vedas say that you're obligated to father, you're obligated to mother, you're obligated to neighbor, you're obligated to nature, you're obligated, full of obligations, because we all take from them. So in spiritual life also, unless there is gratitude for receiving anything from anyone, in our heart, we need to have that in our heart. Then we receive more, then we receive more, then we receive more. So then attachment comes to Prabhupada. Otherwise attachment is not simply, attachment has to be based on some flow. And you are not able to identify that flow, but that's why I'm trying to elaborate. What is that flow that is coming from Prabhupada? He feels that you are mine, you are my disciple. That is why Divya Gyan Hriday Prakashita. That's why you're getting this knowledge. Then the Supreme Lord. Attachment to the Supreme Lord. Again, that is given by Prabhupada. Because from Prabhupada you have heard how you are his part and parcel. You know, you have Shraddha in Prabhupada, what he says. Really, I have no existence. Prabhupada says, no, you have no existence other than the so-called you that is in existence without Krishna is called Ahankara. It is a ghost. If you are living a life of identity, forgetful of Krishna, it is a ghostly life. So most of the people in the material world are living like ghosts. Ghost means what? Not as what they are, but as somebody else. Haunted. They're living a haunted life. So only devotees who come to Prabhupada and Krishna consciousness, they stop being haunted little by little. Still they get haunted. So how much by taking Harinam medicine you de-haunt yourself? That much we feel our original sense of belonging with Krishna. So one sense of belonging is there, attachment is there. And then there is service, then there is reciprocation. Knowledge itself brings attachment. Then further, when there is service and reciprocation, attachment deepens. Attachment is that there is no question of sense gratification, all these cannot attract. That is the secret. The whole process given by Prabhupada to us, Shravanam, Kirtanam, all meant for developing this attachment. Any other question?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Is spiritual attachment and spiritual sentiment are both same?
Spiritual attachment and?
And spiritual sentiment. Is there anything, something called spiritual sentiment? Or devotees can maintain spiritual sentiments?
Attachment is through sentiments only, no? But what context do you use the word sentiment?
Example, Prabhu, let us say devotee is having fever.
Fever
has come.
Fever.
So every day he comes and attend Mangala Arati like that. So when fever is there, he feels that still I have to go and have darshan like that. So is it good, these kind of feelings, or?
If fever is there also, if possible, go and have darshan, very good. If you think that, fever is there, it is raining outside, and I have no umbrella, I should go and have darshan. That is imitation of real attachment. It is not real attachment. We should understand our limitations. At this stage of my Krishna consciousness, my bhakti cannot be so much that I can forget my fever and go in the rain for darshan. So there is a, when it comes to feeling towards the deity, towards spiritual master, towards everything, there are two stages, Raghanuga stage and Vaidhi stage. Vaidhi means you are in a stage where not spontaneous feelings, but you accept feelings that are favorable for devotion service and reject feelings that are unfavorable for devotion service. Then there is Raghanuga stage, where there is no filtration of feelings, of whether I should feel or whether I should not feel, which is favorable, which is unfavorable, because you are already pure. All are favorable. There is no unfavorable feeling at all in you. Every feeling that you have is favorable for devotion service. It's an advanced stage. So we should definitely have a check on our feelings also in devotional service. Just like we have feelings, if some Vaishnava helps us, he is not a pure devotee. But we have sentiments for him. But those sentiments will have some circle of limitation. It cannot be, it won't be absolute, like your sentiments for Prabhupada. But does not mean that I have only sentiments for Prabhupada. Prabhupada is teaching us how to have devotional sentiment towards every devotee. That is Guru. He is teaching us. Otherwise, Prabhupada will think he is a neophyte. He only has devotion for me. He is a neophyte. He cannot see my Shakti everywhere. He cannot see our other children. He cannot see. He sees me in a limited form. He does not see that I have thousands of children. And through all those children, I can be satisfied. By serving them, I can be satisfied. He does not know. So sentiments also needs to be regulated at the sadhana stage, at Vaidhi Bhakti stage. And we are practicing Vaidhi Bhakti. Anything else? Grandharachimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.